I specialize in current science and technology. So we have a stage dedicated to science in the news, the latest research on vaccines, the latest space missions. So this really fits in exactly with what we're trying to cover.
I've been teaching astronomy for 4 years. My degrees are in physics, but I did astrophysics specifically. And so it has always been my love.
Personally, I'm both a pilot and an astronomer. This is an airplane with a telescope in it. Oh, this was made for me. They just didn't know it.
Science isn't for scientists. It's for society. It's for people. People need to be passionate about science to see what's going on that real people are doing.
Door is open. We have 10 more minutes before the turn.
I have a live presentation at the Museum of Science called Astronomy at 40,000 Feet. It's about why you would want to put a telescope on a plane, how you put a telescope on a plane, and then what kind of science SOFIA can do that can't be done anywhere else in the world or off of it. So being able to take that show and put in my own experiences where I've directly seen the telescope in flight, I've seen the team interacting with each other, I've seen the science come up on the screen, is going to give it an extra push that a lot of our presentations don't have because we're just reporting on the science.
Yeah, I think that's the best we've ever seen.
So being able to say that I was there while it was being done is just going to give that really incredible edge to
that's
a lot of the presentations.
Yeah, they're way up here.
So, but well, I've integrated a lot of the information about SOFIA into my astronomy elective for this fall. I'm doing a special elective this year where we're focusing on infrared astronomy and looking at SOFIA. But in addition, there's a lot of physics involved in the running of the aircraft, the engineering of the telescope, and in the science, the astronomy that's being done as well. And so I can integrate that into various units of the physics curriculum and give a real-world example and something that's exciting and current that they can be inspired by as well as learn from.
That could be diffraction, but it could be the nebula. It's an opportunity for me to see science in the act of collection, and I need to see that so that my students will be able to get a better idea of what it really is rather than just reading about science in a book or on the internet. My partner and I have been doing an experiment up here, and so we've videotaped cosmic ray hits on a Geiger counter and matched it with elevation and time. And so we're going to hand them over these videos of the data and then expect them to come up with how they're going to process it, make sense out of it, to see what the elevation compared to the cosmic ray hits would be.
Yeah, you should see at least 1, 2, 3, 4 stars. Five maybe.
1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, all right, order.
Everybody here is here obviously because they love what they do. And they're all these specialists and these amazingly brilliant people. But not only are they willing to talk to you when you come up and ask them questions, but they overhear our conversations because they're monitoring our chat stations and our discussions here. And they come up and give input to us, and they walk us up to consoles, and they show us how things work. Everybody has been so amazingly engaging and friendly. I've done a lot of things in my life. This is without a doubt one of the most amazing things I have ever had, and I will cherish it for the rest of my life. It's just such a privilege.
There you go. There's the image up on the screen. Beautiful.
Woo!
Oh, yeah. Run.
Looking. It's awesome.